was a little different, you know, right?
As you can see, you know, in Italy, we don't put no sombrero on Jesus' head. Okay,
so you see everything's a little different. Everybody's a little different. So that's how it started. But you cannot maintain this way in the modern world. See? Some nationalities still do. Some do. You know, like the Eastern Rite, you know, like the Orthodox, they still maintain, you know, this way. We don't any longer. So now we look to think what they say. I'm sorry, I use all these colloquialism, all these things to, yeah, we shouldn't be using. But there's a term in English that's called think outside the box. Have you heard this?
Yes.
Think outside the box. So now, Catholic education, and especially Loyola, which this is, you're doing a very good thing to come through Loyola, they're thinking outside the box. Because we have to. We have to. We cannot think of the same way, right? You know, 30 kids, row, 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 I sit there, you know, da, 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 da. We can't do this. So we have to. So education is changing, so hopefully you will go back to Brazil and take a little bit of these things. Now, all in the same, São Paulo, where everybody, or just all over?
Many places.
Oh, many places
from Brazil.
And you have all the name of the schools and where they're all?
I don't know where everybody is. It seems like a lot of them are from the south.
Okay. Yes.
In southeast part.
If,
south
if
east.
I can, here, real simple. We will do the old fashioned. Because this, now, mundo nuevo. So then, you want a student to send something to America, you want to have connection with students in America, you got 900 kids here, from little chiquitos. I don't know how you say it in Portuguese, how you say little, little?
Yes.
From the little one all the way to the, they're real big, you know. So yeah, so this is my email, work all over the world. Right? Uh-huh. Maybe yes, maybe no.
Yeah.
I can give you a telephone, but that's
expensive.
Okay.
Maybe by Skype?
Skype and things, yeah. Oh, yeah. Because I think this teacher would love to. Yeah, why not? You know? The things. I'm sorry we don't teach Portuguese here. But you could. They would love, I'm sure. Why not? You know, we have international club. We have club, international club. So maybe. So that's the thing. Don't worry, you can raise your hand. Lady Oldway, do you have a question? My name, Joe. It's Joseph. But in Italian, it's Giuseppe.
Yes.
And when my mother said Giuseppe to the nurse, the lady looked at me like, what? No, American. What? So she said, well, what is that? So my father said, well, they call my grandfather, because I named my grandfather, they said, well, they call him Joe at work. So what did they come up with? So it went Brahma.
Giuseppe.
Which is Joseph, yeah. Went to Joe. Then they asked, what's the middle name? Oh, it's even worse. Middle name is Giovanni. So they say, oh, what? So they say, spell it. So my mother said G. That's it. Joe G. That's it. So my legal name is Joe G. The young lady who's from America will know Sanford and Son, right? Okay. Sanford's son was Fred G. Sanford. So.
And in Brazil, your name is Jose.
Jose?
Yes.
Jose. Well, very good. I'm very glad to be Jose with you and bring back nice memories of those poor Brazilians. I hope, I'm pretty sure things are much better for them now. But I remember it was tough times because they were freezing. Oh my God! They came with the, you know, with the flip flops. We never saw flip flops, you know, because only girls wore flip flops, you know, in the '70s, you know, talking years ago. So when I was in the seminary and you saw these people, men with the flip flops, you know, this is the Brazilian people, and But you know, it's 20 degrees out. Because they had nothing. They came from Brazil with nothing. Oh my God.
So to see them all with the thing, you know. So it was a very, very good experience.
So any question? I've been doing so much talk, I'm sorry.
Just a curiosity, what happened to these Brazilians when you thought?
Well, like I said, they were when I left Canada, they were all basically the government said, you know what, this is not their problem. So the United Nations went after these people, because you know what they did? It wasn't the beginning of it. These guys, they went from Brazil, they went to Argentina, and they did the same thing. Whatever they could find, oh yeah, they were doing all in South America, they were doing this. They'd come up, big thing, give you house, give you job, give you this, do this. You had to basically sell
all the
property.
Yeah,
and so basically what they did was, this was all rural Brazil, because they wanted the land. See, so they got people in the same town, right? They know everybody, hey, you're related to him, and this is my friend because they live next door to me, and you know, so this is, so they say, okay, you sell, all together, go to Canada. Beautiful. They you know, and you know, if you got nothing, and you give you promise, and they come with paper, document, and everything, and they give you document that's stamped with the, you know, Canada visa, which is English, French, right? Who can read that, mm-hmm. right? If you can barely read. So yeah, it was a good thing. But you know, the church, because you see, the community that I was in was a religious order, and I think they are in Brazil. Scalabrinians. Mm-hmm. This is the missionary society that was started to help the Italian, because you know, at one time America, no Italian could come to America. After 1920, it was a law. So it was quota. So no more Italian coming to America. So where'd they go? Argentina, Brazil, Canada, you know? So, see? So the Scalabrinians, this group of priests, you know, like the Jesuits who run Loyola, right? This group of priests were started by Saint John Baptist Calabrini to take care in those countries. So, and Bishop Scalabrini, he went to Brazil. He visited Brazil, you know? Like Mario Cabrini, you know, these people like were crazy, you know? In those times with a boat, you know, no airplane, right? You know, and they travel and they help the community because they were struggling. So the Scalabrinian, who were in Canada to help the Italian, okay, they switch. No more, just because their name used to be Pious Society of St. Charles Borromeo for the Italian immigrant. Their whole name was that. Then they changed it because the Italian didn't need any help anymore, okay, basically. So they said, you know what, we're going to help the other immigrant. So at that time, so they take care of the Brazilian. So they took care. So there was, oh my God, there was Father Enzo, he was crazy. This guy was crazy. You know what you do? They were incredible. It was amazing. They, you don't have a job? I give you a job. So this priest, he used to go to all these Canadian business and say, you have to hire Consuela, or you have to hire, you know, Rodrigo, or you have to hire. The priest used to go and say, you have to hire. And then if he couldn't hire him, he gave him a job. They have an attic, you know, with a roof, you know, they have the attic, you know, the attic. So they have the attic. He have a workshop, they like St. Joseph. And he have a plaque. You have all these clocks. So you have this business giving clocks. Clock, you know, clock, mechanism. Mm-hmm. You know, the clock, okay. So the Brazilian, they're like 20 guys in the attic, all making clocks. Oh. Oh yeah. So he said, you don't hire? Give me. He said, I'm making that. So then the Brazilian make the clock, they sell the clock, they make money. Oh yeah, he was ingenious. And he was missionary in Iran, when they had the Shah of Iran, you know,